And a good Monday, everybody. Joel here with the J7409 weather forecast for today. Now, of course, can you believe it? Last day of August, 31st of August, 2020. Heading on into September by after midnight. August just flew right by us, didn't it? What we're looking at here, everybody, is the WRF models, the ARWRF models, and what this is sister model to the Hurricane Weather and Research Force model, which you hear a lot of talk about during hurricanes, the HWRF. Now, these models that you're looking at, they're very, very good at tracking systems, little rain systems. I'm not talking about hurricanes or tropical storms right now. I'm just talking about general rain that's coming up and where it may. This is what a lot of the meteorologists use that you'll see on TV when they point up and zoom in on your area of where the rain showers are. So we've got the West Gulf of Mexico, Florida, the East Coast, and the Northeast, and we're going to check all of these out individually coming up on J7409 weather. Let's go ahead and knock these out of the way. You can see a timestamp right down here. August 31st started at midnight tonight. We will turn it on and just let it roll. It should go through tomorrow at least. And you can see this is the Gulf Coast states that we're zooming in on now for where some showers may occur during this time. Tomorrow looks like, well, today rather, later in the day, we got some that's going to go across the Texas Panhandle up into Oklahoma and over into Arkansas by tomorrow morning. You can see this rain as it's picking up. You can actually see different counties in this. You know where you live, and you will see if this rain will affect you in any way. Once again, this is for the Gulf Coast states. These maps are provided by My Fox Hurricane. I want to put that in here. We're looking at Florida now. Here's your time stamp. Looking like pretty good for a while, but later on, today should look fairly well to this afternoon. As you can see now, this afternoon, you are going to have some rain showers start to pop up, and they are going to clear up by tomorrow. Tomorrow's looking great for the whole state of Florida. Just a few splash and dash showers. Later this afternoon, though, as you saw, they are going to fire up, move on through, so be prepared for it. Now, as it moves across, here we go, starting out today. I want to bring this to your attention once again. Here's your timestamp for today. Each hour of the day is what these maps show. You can see right down in here by this afternoon, say around 3, 4, 5 o'clock, you are going to have some good thunder showers to pop up, so be aware. Here we have a look at the East Coast coming up for today and tomorrow. Over in eastern Tennessee, parts of Kentucky, West Virginia, and Virginia, by later this afternoon, those thunderstorms are going to start to pop up for you guys too, as you can see. This is the system we're watching as it comes off the Florida coast. You can tell nothing going on with it at this time. Through tomorrow, it's going to get up off of our coast of NC, as you can see. Probably not developing till later as it moves on out, but it should develop later on in time. And last but not least, we're going to check out the Northeast all the way from the northeastern coast of North Carolina all the way up through Delaware, New Jersey, New York, moving straight on up to Maine. You can see what should be happening. As of today, most of the showers are going to be confined to the Appalachian Trail areas in North Carolina. A few along the coast, not bad at all, but we saw that in the northeastern track forecast just a while ago. Looking ahead to tomorrow and right on through September 2nd, this is what it's looking like for you guys. We'll let it run through right quick for today one more time so you can be aware if you have any chance of any kind of thunderstorms popping up coming your way. And we will check the severity of these storms as they move through in the severe weather outlook. As we check out the severe weather that may happen today across the lower 48, you can see we do have these severe thunderstorms that are possible for parts of the lower Missouri River Valley into the southern plains, and other strong storms may occur from the Central Carolinas into eastern West Virginia, as we just saw pop up on the WRF model. We saw those heavier cloud tops forming and producing some thundershower activity up in this area here. This is where it is enhanced. We saw this for the Gulf model we just showed for parts of Texas, Oklahoma, parts of Missouri, and Arkansas. Chance of tornadoes out of all of this is 2% today through Virginia and North Carolina. Also, Oklahoma, just a little bit of Kansas, a little bit of Missouri, and Arkansas. Now, the wind, it's going to breeze up. It's going to blow down in Texas and Oklahoma, Missouri, and parts of Arkansas at a 15% enhanced area here. 5% chance may get a little breezy for some of us all the way up into West Virginia, down to South Carolina. When it comes to large hail, this is significant hail. This is probably going to happen in Oklahoma today. Any of these thundershowers that do pop up and form these cells and the humidity and everything else with all of the atmospheric conditions. I can't get it out this morning, folks. I'm stuttering. I'm sorry. But anyway, you get the point. Large hail is going to occur in this area. So please be aware of this. If you see any of these storms making up in your area, please, please make sure you can take shelter. I will have a quick check of what's going on from the National Hurricane Center just a little bit and a complete tropical update later this afternoon. But right now, if you haven't subscribed and you're into the weather, please do so. Please click subscribe, click that bell, check off all to make sure you get all of my latest weather videos as I put them out. If you don't make sure all is checked off, you probably won't get them. This map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits, is the NAM map. It's what should happen through the next 3 days across the lower 48. We'll turn it on and let it roll. We got heavy rainfall and flash flooding threats across parts of the central Appalachians as well as the south central plains. Several severe weather possibilities today for parts of the southern plains into the Missouri Valley, as I've showed you. Hot again. Heat advisories in effect for parts of the south, while much below normal temperatures will overspread the northern Rockies and the plains. And then we got that locally heavy rain that's possible in the southwest, while fire weather remains a great threat across the central Great Basin. Now, it's looking like we have a boundary that's expected to generally bring unsettled conditions across much of the deep south, with a warm and humid air mass today. Now, these heat advisories remain in effect across parts of southern and eastern Texas and to Louisiana, where your daytime highs are going to be in the 90s to near 100, and the heat indices are going to make it feel hotter, of course. And behind this front, a much cooler air mass will overspread the northern and central Rockies and plain states, with daytime highs around 10 to 20 degrees below normal. Now, listen to this, folks. Temperatures may be cold enough to support mixed precipitation or even some light snow in the higher elevations of the northern Rockies as well. Monsoon moisture into parts of the southwest will continue that threat for locally heavy rainfall through Tuesday. To the north, dry and windy conditions on the backside of the cold front. It's going to bring some elevated to critical fire weather concerns across the central Great Basin, where widespread red flag warnings are already in effect. Upper level ridging should build across the west coast states by Tuesday, with above normal temperatures likely. And elevated fire weather concerns should also shift northward into the northern high plains, as another cold front ushers in dry weather and gusty winds. And as we take a quick look at the tropical outlook from the National Hurricane Center, this says 2 a.m. It's really not. This is the last time I set it on the 5-day graphical outlook, so you could actually see where these things are pointed, okay? Now, we're going to start out right over here, disturbance number 2. This area you saw it moving off the coast with rain mostly all out to sea, a little bit here and there, splashing up in South Carolina and North Carolina. It's not going to be a problem for us, though, folks. I do not believe it's going to form once it gets out into the ocean. That's when it should form. Shouldn't hurt us right now. That's what it's looking like anyway. It's just an area of low pressure a few hundred miles east of Jacksonville, Florida. It's gradually got a little better organized during the past 24 hours, but currently producing only limited shower and thunderstorm activity. Additional development is expected, and a tropical depression is likely to form by the middle of the week while the system moves northeast or east-northeastward, initially parallel to the southeastern coast of the U.S. and then away from land. Now, upper-level winds are expected to become less conducive for further development by Wednesday. 2 days, 60% chance. 5 days, 70% chance. Now, when we come over here to disturbance number one, I've been watching this closely, folks. I'm not saying this is going to happen, but it could eventually slip into the Gulf here. I'm not saying right now it's going to. All the models, except for a few, have it just going over like I showed you yesterday in the tropical update. That's a very good possibility. But there is that slight possibility it could slip into the Gulf. But as of right now, the recent satellite imagery and satellite-derived wind data indicate that this broad area of low pressure associated with a tropical wave over the eastern Caribbean Sea has changed little in organization since yesterday. However, though, the environmental conditions are expected to gradually become more conducive for development, and a tropical depression is likely to form during the next couple of days while the system moves to the westward areas, moving westward at around 15 to 20 miles per hour. Now, interest in Jamaica, Honduras, Belize, Guatemala, and the Yucatan Peninsula, you need to pay attention to what's going on with this, okay? Formation in 2 days is 70%, 5 days is 80% chance. I do not know. Do not ask me if it's going to hit Jamaica. We have to wait and see. It's still way out here. I cannot tell you. We're going to have to follow it. When I see danger to Jamaica or any of these areas that I've just told you the National Hurricane Center is telling you to be aware of, I will put it up there. Right now, it's still way out here. I would advise, though, it's mighty close in this cone area to Jamaica. You could get some effects from it. So just watch it, and we'll see what happens. Now, let's get to number three. It's a tropical wave. It's expected to emerge off the coast of Africa in a couple of days. Now, gradual development of this system will be possible through the end of the week, and it's moving slowly westward over the eastern tropical Atlantic Ocean. 2 days, nothing. It's still on land, folks. It can't do anything. 5 days, 30% chance. I'm telling you, here it is right here, as you can see. It is going to get stronger. I don't know if it will last, but once it gets off the coast, as you've seen in all the satellite data and everything else that I've showed you in some models, looking like it is going to get stronger. And we really, really, everybody, all of us, need to watch this system. For disturbance number four, it's just a tropical wave steer, and it's several hundred miles southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. This system's producing little shower activity, and development of this system should be very slow to occur as it moves slowly westward. It's got a zero chance in 2 days and 10% in 5 days. And right now, I'm keeping my eyes on it. Doesn't look like it's going to be a big threat as of yet to any of the island areas. However, that could change too. So we got to keep up on it. And like I said, I'll have a complete tropical update late this evening for you with everything that I found throughout the day is how these things are developing or disorganization is occurring to them. Thank you so much for watching. You have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. I love you all and thank you for everything you do for me. and may each and every one of you find much peace, love, and kindness in your lives today. Thanks for watching.